Okay, so good afternoon. So let us start with today's class. Can anyone of you give the recap of the previous class? I don't want the same people. Any other new persons? So here and after, if you're coming for the late, if you're coming late for the class, you will be marked as absent. Is it okay? Like, I'll inform you again once the class is over. I wanted all you to be on time to class. If there is going to be any delay in the previous class ending, you can let me know so that I'll start the meeting late. Is it okay? Any responses?
In last class, we discussed about planning, ma'am. How to plan. We discussed different methods like bar graph, PRT and CPM.
Yeah.
And then what finally MCP? End the class with bar graph.
Yeah, we started with the planning and we entered into networking. So different methods for networking is nothing but the bar charts, milestone charts, followed by your CPMs and PERTs. We went into our bar charts. So I hope you have tried the example too. Did you? Few of you at least? No, ma'am, we are very busy with our all our steps. We are not able to do that now. That's just a training for you. Okay. So we have seen two examples related to this. And now we are going to see the next part. That is, you know how the bar chart will be and the advantages of bar chart, because it's going to be a pictorial representation. So it will be easy for anyone to understand the particular duration versus the time period. So it will be easy for them to assess it. Now, when we are coming to the shortcomings or remedial measures, so what is the major drawback there is going to be the lack of degree of details. When an activity is assigned for some longer duration, say example 10 days or 20 days, so that time you will not be able to know what are all the complete activities that are going to take place in the 10 days. So in that case, you are having a lack of degree of detail there, because each and every activity is not explained there. Generally, like when it is coming to laying of foundation, you take some 10 days or 15 days. That goes to be the activity. In that case, you will not be having each and every particulars in detail. So it is a drawback when you come to bar charts. So we will see this one example. You have six activities here. Oh, sorry, five activities here. First is remove existing machine. So that takes about 3 days. Dispose of existing machine. Again, that it takes from the 3rd till your 8th day. And await delivery of new machine. That is from 0 to 4th day. Can you see this horizontal boxes? Okay. And get new power installation. When you're going to install new electricity cables, that time you need 2 days. And install new machines. For that you require 3 days. That is from 4th till 7th. So these are nothing but the different type of activities where it is not given much in detail. When it comes to dispose of existing machine, you should know like what are the different types of machines there, which should be removed first and which should be removed next. So all those details are not given clearly in this bar chart. So what happened is later when people started doing research regarding this pictorial representation of all your activities in your bar chart, they came out with some improvements from further corrections or suggestions, telling that they could be mentioning the different categories of tasks done under a single activity. So nothing but you take this dispose of existing machine, where the span is from 3 to 8 years. So it's 8 days, which means 5 days works are going on, maybe days or months, days, weeks or months. That time, this gives you, this arrow mark represented by the notation will tell you what is the specific activity that is being taken place in that particular tenure of 5 days. So here it is noted by the upside arrow mark with a notation. So A is notation. It is nothing but dumping machine into store. Next is followed by activity B. It is nothing but notice inviting bidding. And activity C is nothing but finalization of the highest bid. And D, it is a final disposal of the machine. So when you are going to dispose the existing machine, you need these four different categories of tasks to be carried out in a particular time span. That's the reason like they are improvising this existing bar chart. Can see this is the existing bar chart. This they are improvising by inserting an arrow mark and noting it with a particular job specification. Here the notations are A, B, C, D. It can be either 1, 2, 3 or any other different type of notations. Whichever you are giving, whatever notations you are mentioning here, the same must be mentioned in the description also. And next is the review of project progress. So this is what I told you. This is the review of project progress. You do any project, you review it. Only then you will be able to know where you are. Probably in the month of in the month of February, you have completed some tasks. You should know that what was your deadline. Probably your activity is from 0 till 6 weeks. And your activity number 1 has been assigned for 6 weeks. And this dashed or the striped line denotes that it has been completed in 4 weeks. Which means you are 2 weeks in lead. You're completing it prior to your deadline. And second activity, it starts from 3rd week and it ends at 11th week. Here the span is 8 weeks. In this case, your activity 2 has been scheduled for 8 weeks, but you are able to complete that activity within 5 weeks itself. And the activity 3, it is for 2 weeks and you completed it on time. When it comes for your 4th activity, starts from the 2nd week. See, this is the 4th activity. This 4th activity starts from your 2nd week and it gets continued till your 9th week. This is how you have to match it. You have to match your activity along with your time. So it is on time. This, the undisturbed horizontal box that's going to be your proposed or the estimated time, whereas this striped line or the dashed line, this represents that it is going to be your complete task completed on time. And this is your 5th activity. Here still you have not yet started this process. Okay, so this is how the review of every activity has been carried out. Sometimes different colors are filled. So this is how it came, it started its growth from the original bar chart. It started with the original bar chart, then it came out with the improvised bar chart by the arrow mark specifications, and then it went on with the review of project progress. It's not only like having only the schedule, we cannot know where we are. We should mark along with it, we should mention how much we have completed and within how many days. In some cases, what will happen is probably this your activity has been scheduled for 2 weeks. Sometimes it may take your 3rd week as well. It depends upon the environmental situations, climatic conditions, your worksite environment, where maybe due to equipment delivery may be late or due to your manpower shortage. There may be so many reasons. Probably your materials will not be delivered to your worksite on time. So there may be deviations in your estimated work. So sometimes different colors are filled in the bars to show various control information as indicated below. So this is going to be the control information. This is the information and this is the colors specified for that. So anticipated progress is mentioned in black color. Actual progress, you are representing that using green color. And progress behind schedule, that goes under red color. Progress beyond schedule, which means it's nothing but you are lagging there. That situation you go for red color. Actual progress is you're comparing the proposed one with the actual one. So you are in the right progress, you are showing it in the green. Okay. So next topic is activity interrelationship. So we saw what is an activity. There are list of activities that has to be taken care of when you start your construction work. From the start till the end date, you have number of activities to be fulfilled, to be performed. So you are going to interconnected, or you are going to understand what is an interrelationship between them. So in a project, there may be a large number of activities which can start with a certain degree of concurrency. Example, take a project of laying a pipeline. So now we are going to see an example related to the laying of a pipeline. You have 3 different activities. The first activity is excavating the trench. That takes you 12 weeks. So excavate, you can name it as A. A is nothing but activity name is A, and the description is excavate from here, from the 0th till 12th week. So I'm going to mark it in my sleeping line. You should call it the horizontal box. You're going to put it. That is your excavating the trench. And the activity B is laying and joining the pipe. That takes 10 weeks. That starts when after the 2 weeks completion of my activity A. So I'm marking it here, lay and join pipes. Similarly, my activity C is going to be refilling and compacting. That case, the total schedule is going to be only 6 weeks. So it starts from the 10th week and it ends at my 16th week. So this is my activity interrelationship. So this is my original chart. When I am going to modify this, I'll be having this. This you can simply call it as modified bar chart or improved bar chart. So when I am into my excavation process, I can list what are the different types of activities I'm going to take under this head activity A. So these are the sub activities that has to be taken care under the activity A. Similarly, when it comes to lay and join pipes under my activity B, I'm having 4 different sub activities, 1, 2, 3, 4. When I come to activity C, again, I'm having 4 different activities, which is starting on that particular day. So this is improvised chart. We saw what is the shortcoming and how to overcome the shortcoming is we saw the implementation of the improved or the modified bar charts. Then we saw how the review of bar charts are done and what are the colors used for it. And now we'll see milestone charts. Milestone chart is a modification over the original Gantt chart. You can literally your bar charts are otherwise known as Gantt chart because it was originated by Henry Gantt. So it is named after him. Milestones are the key events of main activity represented by a bar. These are specific points in time which mark the completion of certain portions of the activity. When a bar chart, big details are not clear, in that situation, we can subdivide it or we can classify into sub activities and you can establish the interrelationship. This is what we have done. It is very large here. A schedule of 12 weeks. 12 weeks is nothing but what is 12 weeks when you convert to months? It's going to be 1.5 months. In that situation, quite large time where you need to carry multiple number of activities there. So for that reason, we are subcategorizing or you are giving the characterization into sub activities. So you are mentioning it as activity 1, 2, 3, 4 for A activity. Under the A activity, you have 4 different sub activities. Similarly, for activity B, you have 4. Similarly, for activity C, you have 4. The beginning and end of this subdivision activities or tasks are termed as milestones. So this is my Gantt charts. Task A, B, C, where I'm mentioning it with the sleeping line or the sleeping box. This is my horizontal box. Okay, so this is my Gantt milestone chart. So you are going to mark it with a dotted line. The dotted line, you will be representing it by a circle where you will be mentioning the sub activities. So sub activity 1, sub activity 2, that takes place under the task A. Similarly, you can name it when you come to activity B. So here you are naming it as 1, 2 and you are following that numeral here. It is third activity, fourth activity, fifth activity. So you can tell there are 3 different sub-activities, 1, 2, 3. 3 different sub-activities under the task B. And the names are third activity, fourth activity, fifth activity. Similarly, when you come for activity C, you have the sixth and seventh activity, that is 2 activities. And when you come to the task D, you have 3 activities. It is named as 8, 9 and 10. So this is the modification of bar chart into a milestone chart. So each main task contains some specific points in time which can be easily recognized and through which controlling can be also achieved. Each milestone can be considered to be specific event along the main activity or the job or the task that has to be accomplished. So each milestone you are going to consider to be the specific event. So that's the reason we didn't name it as 1, 2, 3 here. It is going to be the continuation in order to complete our task. So our project is going to have 4 different tasks, that is A, B, C, D. For that, we are fixing this as a milestones. So activity 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 are going to be your milestones. Okay. So this chart is therefore called as milestone chart. Each milestone is represented either by a circle or by a square, and it is serially marked. If it is going to be serially marked, then it falls as your milestone. If it's going to carry an upward direction arrow mark along with any different type of notation, that is going to be your modified or improved charts. Next, we are entering into CPM and PERT. So CPM or PERT, they are the network models and are used as an aid in the scheduling of large complex projects that consist of many activities. So if I am doing a construction project where I have some 20 number of activities, so is it possible for me to plot 20 activities in a paper or a chart? Is it possible? Is it possible for me to sit and plot all the 20 different charts in a sheet of paper or in a chart? Is it possible? Kindly answer. Anyone?
No, ma'am.
Is it not possible? I have only 20 activities, no? Why can't I put all my 20 activities in a piece of paper or in a piece of chart and just make a hangout there? Why can't I do that? It's only 20, no? Yesterday we saw an example of an activity where you had 14 number of activities. That could be done in a piece of paper, probably a long space. It comes to 20 activities, definitely you can. You can do it, you can draw it easily. So when it comes to young number of activities, it comes to huge numbers, say example quantum, you have 50 or you have 100 different activities and sub activities where you cannot put all together into your chart. So in that situation, we are using networking model as our tool. So we are going to use this network modeling, and like it will be making more time saving, as well as it is easy for you people to understand when you start drawing or mapping your networks using your CPM or your PERT models. If it is going to be less number of activities, you can do that well with your bar charts or with your modified charts or with your milestone charts. So when it comes to huge number of activities, you cannot do that manually. You require softwares, or you require creation of models, network models. That network models, it can be done with the two different types. One is the CPM and the PERT. So when it comes to critical path method, you call it as CPM. Duration of each activity is known with certainty. You should know, for if I'm going to carry over my first activity, that takes 10 days. So you're having four activities. You should know what number of days it requires. Only then you'll be able to move on with your CPM. Used to determine the length of time required to complete a project. So you have five activities, all the all the durations of the five activities are given, which means you have five activities. So you say it is A, B, C, D, E. This is your five activity. Okay, so I am taking like this. This may be the one path, this may be the another path, and this may be by third path. So I know all there are five activities and there are five different time durations. I should know what is the actual length required. Will I be able to calculate? I know all the duration. So is there any possibility to calculate? Can I? Okay, I can, because having all the durations in hand, I should possibly identify which path should I choose to reach my destination and calculate the entire length. So I'll be able to calculate the length of the time required to complete this project. I know that A is going to be my start activity and E is the completion or the end activity. That time I have three different paths. Either I can go from A, B to E, or I can go from A, C to E, or I can go from A, D to E. I have three different paths. If I follow any of this path, I'll be able to identify my length of the project completion. And CPM can also be used to determine how long each activity in the project can be delayed without delaying the completion of the project. If I go by this path A, B, E, I'll be getting one value. Probably this is 5 and this is 2. Then if I follow A, B, E activity, I'll be getting my duration as 7 days. Can you understand? This 5 plus 2. I submit and I get it as 7. When I go by the C method, I'll be having probably say example 3, example 7. When I follow A, C, E, I'll be getting 3 plus 7. 3 plus 7 is 10. So when I follow this D, it is 4 and 3. So when I go by this A, D, E method, I'll be getting a summation of 7. So for different path, you get different durations. Remember, the paths and the durations are not going to be the same. Each and every activity, it will be requiring different durations. So when you follow a particular path, so this is our path. When I follow this particular path, I will definitely be getting one value. And that value will not be the same when I follow the another path. So the values, the durations for the particular activity following the different paths are going to be different. Okay. And CPM was developed in the year 1950s. And next is our PERT model. This PERT model is nothing but program evaluation and review technique. Duration of each project is not known. It is not known with certainty. When it comes to your CPM, you know all your durations, activities duration. You have 5 activity. You have 3 different path. You know all your values. Whereas when you come to PERT, you don't know what is the duration. Used to estimate the probability that project will be completed by the given deadline. You have to estimate whether there is any probability to complete the project within the stipulated time or not. For that only we are going to evaluate, or you are going to carry some probabilities, that probability analysis, and you are going to tell me that whether you will be able to meet up your deadline or not. PERT was developed around the same time as that of CPM. So both were started around the year 1950s. There are some basic terminologies used in CPM and PERT. This goes to be the common terminologies. It's not separate for PERT and CPM. It is going to be a common terminologies for CPM and PERT. So the first terminology is going to be your activity. What is meant by activity? What is an activity? Yes. Anyone of you? What is an activity?
Operations which take some time to carry out.
Yeah, operations that takes time to complete. What you do? You need to perform any operation. Only then you will be accomplishing your task. Okay. So activity is nothing but an effort that requires resources. Without any resource, you cannot do your work. Is the slide visible? Okay. An activity is defined as an effort that requires resources and takes certain amount of time for completing the task, whatever may be the activity. You wake up in the morning, you start studying, you fix some time. You need some books or source or internet or your laptop or your mobile. That's the nothing but the resources. So you need time as well as a resource to put up things, to carry on things, to perform activities, to perform any task. So that is called as activity. An activity is defined as a project that can be broken down into various operations and process necessary for its completion. If you start working on only, you'll be able to complete your goal or your deadline. You'll be meeting up your deadline. Each of these operations and processes which consumes time and possibly resources is called activity. You require time as well as you require resources. That is called an activity. So next terminology is critical activity. What is called critical activity? Critical activity is defined as an activity that, if even slightly delayed, will hold up the scheduled completion date of the entire project. Though if it is slightly delayed also, we are in a position to meet our completion date. We'll be able to complete our tasks on time. It is called critical activity. What is meant by event? Anyone of you? Both are same, ma'am. Is it so? Or is there any difference between activity and event? Activity is nothing but the task you perform. Event is the specific goal you reach. Maybe your time, you have some deadline, checkpoint that you're going to meet it up. So event, a specific accomplishment at a recognizable point in time, milestone or checkpoint. Events do not have a time duration per second. To reach an event, all activities that precede it must be completed. So if I'm having activity A and these are my two events. My activity is going to be excavate trench. When I'm starting my first activity, only then I'll be able to complete my second. So for the completion of B, I require the start or the progress of A. This is precede. Precede is the previous one. This is succeed. Succeed is the next one or the forthcoming one. So when I compare A, B events here, my A is going to be the preceding event and B is going to be my succeeding event. So this is how you call. This is a simple two-node diagram. So when you go to a number of network diagram, you have to exit and analyze which is the immediate predecessor and which is the immediate successor. Which is the immediate previous one and which is the immediate successor one. Okay. So event is the state between the completion of a preceding activity and the beginning of the succeeding one. It has no duration. An event is shown either by a circle or by ellipse. You have to just mark like this. So I'm marking from this event to this event. So this is going to be for my activity A, this is my start point and this is my end point for this particular activity A. Start point and start event and my end event. Next is network. So what is meant by network? You have seen what is meant by activity, what is meant by event. You know all both. Now you are moving to network. What is meant by network? Network is a logical and chronological set of activities and events graphically illustrating the relationship among the various activities and events of the project. You know what are the logical set of activities and chronological set of activities. So you know what are the activities that are going to take place and what are the events. You are going to put all together into a single thing. In a single plate, you have the entire meals ready in your restaurants, right? You have all your rice, maybe your roti, maybe your gravy, whatever other thing you follow, all those things will be there in your plate. Within a plate, you have everything. It's literally nothing, but you have all your activities, networks, events, everything done in a single thing. It's called network. Where it tells you like which should be followed after which. You're going to interconnect it. You're going to start the relationship between other activities. So next is going to be the path. Path is nothing but the sequence of adjacent activities that form a continuous path between two events. So this is my event A, this is my event B. this is my path. This line which I am connecting is my path. And activity, critical path. Critical path is nothing but sequence of critical activities that forms a continuous path between the start of the project and its completion. So you know what is path? Literally, for critical path, it's nothing but you have critical activities, which means though it is, what is my critical activity? Though there is a delay also, delay in the schedule also, we are able to meet up the deadline. That is called your critical activity. That activity which you are performing is a critical activity. So the path which is following the critical activities are going to be your critical path. Sequence of critical activities that forms a continuous path between the start of the project and the completion of the project. Not only these two events, I have number of events here. Probably I may have 4 or 5 events in my project. So I am having 5 events. So this is going to be my one path, this is going to be my another path, and this is my third path. So I'm going to calculate all the paths. This is the duration of all the path and identify which is taking the maximum. So if there is going to be delay also, what is in my critical activity? We saw that if there is going to be any delay also, we are able to finish our deadline. I mean, finish our activities before the deadline. So we are going to analyze all the three durations, the three paths, and we have to identify which is the maximum path, maximum amount of duration. So that is going to be our critical path. Probably in the previous case, I think I have erased. So in this example, when you take this first path, you are getting the total activity as 7, and here you are getting as 10, and here you are getting 8, and here you are getting as 10, which means activity A, C, and E provides you 10, which is nothing but ACE forms your critical path, where these other critical activities, though there is the delay in time, I'm able to meet up my project, I'm able to complete my project. So the longest duration is going to be your critical path. And it is the longest path through the network. So I have my first path here, that is 7, and my second path here, that is 10, and my third path is going to be 8. So which is my critical path here? 10, the longest path. Longest path is nothing but the critical path. I'm going to get my longest path, 10, as my critical path for this particular network diagram. So the significance of critical path. Critical path is the longest path in the network. However, it is possible for a network to have one or more critical path. It is possible when you have huge number of activities involved in a network diagram, that time we'll be having, there are different durations for different activities. When you start summing up, one or two may be having the critical path, not even one or two. At times you may even have 3 to 4 when you're dealing with more than 50 to 100 number of activities. You'll be having more number of critical path activities. The sum of durations of the critical activities along the critical path determines the duration of the project. So it's nothing but, I repeat the sentence again, the sum of duration of the critical activities along the critical path determines the duration of the project, which means, shall you go back to the previous slide? So it's nothing but the sum of critical activities. So this is my, I'm having three different path here, which is going to give me the sum. Highest duration is going to be 10 because I have two critical activities here. When I am summing up my critical activities, I am getting a critical path of 10. So this is going to be my critical path. That is A, C, and E. When I go by the path A, C, E, I get my critical path. So I can definitely tell that the duration or the length of the project is going to be 10 days or 10 months or 10 weeks. Whatever may be the units, I can tell that it is going to be A. When my network is following the path A, C, E, I get the duration as 10. So the length of the project is going to be 10 weeks or 10 days or 10 months. So it is most sensitive path. Any change in the duration of the critical activities along the critical path is bound to affect the duration of the entire project. So I have estimated like this. So when I'm working on the project, so I am onto the project when I'm working, like literally I have scheduled 5 here and 5 here. which means 5 days here for the activity A to C, and again for the C to E, I have calculated scheduled as 5 days. So what happens if this 5 is changing into 6? I'm not able to get my labors on that day. I'm not able to finish the task. So my activity is getting transferred from 5 to 6 days. Again, you have 5 here. So this is the same. So this activity is not disturbed. Only my A to C is disturbed. In that case, I have a change here. Changes from 5 to 6. When this is changing, my entire duration will be changing. This will not be 10. So it will be 6 plus 5 is equal to 11. So that is going to be my critical path. So if there is going to be any change in the duration of your critical activity, that is going to directly influence or alter your critical path, which directly reflects your change in length of the project. It should have been completed by 10 days, but I'm not able to complete it. So it is getting completed on the 11th day. Is it clear? Any doubt till this? Yes. If there is going to be any change in the duration of your critical activity, I know this out of this entire network diagram, my AC and CE are going to be my two critical activities. For this activity, if there is going to be any change in the duration, then the entire critical path duration will be varied, which is going to overall change the duration of my project. Okay, you understand? Any doubts? Okay, so next is precedence relationship. So precedence relationship is nothing but you connect your next activity to the previous activity. So when I'm here, this point, the second event, I can tell that this is my preceding node or my event. So I can interconnect it. If I want to pour the concrete first, I should place my reinforcement. So if I should place my reinforcement, I should be ready with my formwork. My formwork is ready. When will my formwork be ready? Once I started excavating my trench, only my formwork will be ready. So it is all connected in the reverse order. So preceding relationship. Precedence relations between activities signify that the activities must take place in a particular sequence. So it goes on in a particular sequential order that we should follow. We cannot break that. Numerous natural sequences exist, or construction activities due to the requirements for structural integrity, regulations and their technical requirements. So due to the any requirements, you will be having the natural sequence. So this natural sequence is, I need to pour my concrete there. For pouring my concrete, I require to place my reinforcement. To place my reinforcement, I should have my formwork ready. To start with my formwork, I should have my trench excavated. So this is the sequential set of activities that should be followed. Next is PERT versus CPM. So this is a very important topic, an important unit in your subject. When we come to PERT or CPM, when you go to your next level, higher level of education, or when you go to your competitive exam, you definitely you do have your CPM or PERT questions in your papers. Because this is how you are going to bring your real-time activities into your paper or your system. You have numerous activities in your work site. You are going to put all together and you can make a person understand what is actually happening. So that is why it is bringing the realistic into the picture. So it is very important. So PERT and CPM are very similar in their approach. However, two distincts are usually made between them. What are the distincts? Let's see. First distinction is relates to the way in which activity duration are estimated. In PERT, 3 estimates are used to form a weighted average of the expected completion time of each activity. This is based upon probability distribution of the completion times. So it is called as probabilistic truths. When you come to PERT, you have 3 time estimates. You use the 3 time estimates and find the average of it to complete that activity. This is purely based upon probability distribution. For this, As this is based upon probability distribution concept, so you can literally call it as probabilistic tool. PERT is a probabilistic tool. When you come to CPM, critical path method, there is only one estimate, only one time estimate is there. So having all the time or the duration of the activities are known, you are going to find out the critical path. Only this is the only thing you can do with your CPM. So you have only one option to estimate the time. So it is only one estimate of duration, that is CPM is a deterministic tool. You can only determine the duration. So it is deterministic tool. The second distinction is that CPM allows an explicit estimate of cost in addition to time. Thus, while PERT is basically a tool for planning and control of time, CPM can be used to control both the time as well as the cost. So when it comes to your PERT, you can do only your planning and controlling of time. Everything related to time only can be done in your PERT. When it comes to CPM, you can control your time, you can control your cost, that is within the budget, you can estimate, that you can do. That can be done in your CPMs. Okay. So a CPM or PERT program provides management. Okay, so let me stop. Okay, I'll finish this line also. A PERT or CPM program provides management with the following information. So we'll see what are the information that this program is going to provide us. So we are going to understand what are the critical activities or the tasks in the project. By knowing that, what all can you tell me? You know what are the critical activities. By having the critical activity, what can you identify? Having the critical activity, what can you find out? Yes, anyone?
Critical path.
Yes, having the critical activities, you will be able to identify the critical path. Having determining the critical path, what will you able to determine at the last? You know your critical activity, you know your critical path, and finally what you are going to determine is your duration of the project or the length of the project. So which activities are non-critical? So in this diagram, you know that, I'm sorry, we have seen that example, you have five events. We have told that this path ACE gives us critical. So from this I can tell my A, C and E are critical activities. If I go by this path, it is going to be critical. Okay. So similar way, if I go by A, B, E, or A, D, E, when I go by this method, I can tell that. So from the CPM, but I can tell that this is my critical path. And this is my non-critical path, ADE, that is my non-critical path, NCP. Similarly, I can also tell that ADE is also my non-critical path. You have to be very clear when you are reading the questions. How they will be twisting your questions is nothing but they will be asking, identify the critical path and calculate the duration for the non-critical path. So in that situation, you will be able to identify that AC is your critical path. And when they are asking you to calculate the duration of the non-critical path, you should mention that the duration of the non-critical path, ADE, is going to be 7 or 8. And when it comes to ADE, and what is the value that you're going to, you have to mention it. You should be very clear. You should understand from the concept. If you're not understanding, like everything will be confusing, only lines and rounds or circles will be there, it will be entirely confusing. If you are not able to understand, kindly stop me there. Ignore regarding your friends, don't worry about them. If you have any doubt, kindly stop me so that I'll explain you again. Okay, and next point is you will be calculating the amount of slack or float on each non-critical activity. In the later slides, I'll tell you what is slack or float. Okay, so from the basics, we'll start with our critical path or non-critical path alone. Then later stage, I'll tell you what is slack or float. If I tell everything, you'll be getting confused. So then we'll be able to identify, like we'll be able to identify the duration. Once if I know my duration, if I know my project is going to be ending at the end of my 10th week, so I can tell that the entire project duration will be finished by 10th week. What is the probability that the project can be completed within a specific day? So, you know, it is tentatively by 10 week. So, will it be possible to complete it or not? So, that is what we are going to do in our PERT. If project is on schedule, behind schedule or ahead of schedule, which means I am on time or I am lagging or I am leading. So, if I am behind, I am lagging on my task. If I am ahead, I am leading. I am leading my activity. I'm leading to meet my deadline. If money spent equal or less than or greater than the budgeted amount on any given date, that is also has to be identified. If there are enough resources available to finish the project on time, so I should know whether I'm having enough resources to complete my task. I know there are going to be three different paths for my activity. I should also know whether I'm having enough resources or enough funding to complete this task. The best way to accomplish the project at the least cost, if a project has to be finished in a shorter time, is to frame your network. Once you start framing your network, you will be able to identify what is the tentative date that you require to complete your tasks. So I need to construct a single BHK. I require 3 months time to complete it. If I require 3 months, when you calculate 3 months, you should make sure what are the durations you give for each and every activity. And what is the critical path? The critical path will tell you the length of the project. So I can determine that my project will be completed by the end of 3 months. Not only calculating on the basis of time, also on the basis of cost. You should know whether you are able to complete this within the budget you have in your hand. That also you should take. So, okay, let me stop with this. Remaining we'll be seeing in the next class. Next class is on Friday. So we'll be seeing the process in